believe that this is week 9 in our life group. And sadly, this week marks the end of what has been an amazing series on leadership that I know will transform our church and our communities. And it's been great hearing the different stories and ways that you've been challenged to set up and meet the needs of others by leading like Jesus. It totally makes my heart sing. And I want to remind you that while the life group and the content of this series is ending, you should continue to pursue developing under the Lead Like Jesus philosophy here at New Break, like your whole lives long. And in a moment, we'll be discussing some of the next steps that you can take to continue on your journey. But before we look at what's next, I want to take a moment as a group to answer a few questions about the last 9 weeks together. So as a group, discuss a part of the teaching in the last 9 weeks that's changed your perspective or served as an aha moment. For example, one of the week's topics or specific sections such as the ego or the way of the carpenter and so forth. And then what surprised you most over the course of the last 9 weeks together? And then have you seen a change in yourself or in the group? So go ahead and celebrate that together. Ralph Sockman, a Methodist preacher of old, said, "What makes greatness is starting something that lives after you. And my vision for you as you embrace this philosophy of leadership is that it would change literally every part of your life, from here at church, to your workplace, to your families, and on into the communities that you live in and serve. And as you embrace this, I hope that you will mentor others and pass it on to them to live out in their realms of influence. And as we move forward as a church, the leadership and I want to support you into developing not just in an area that you serve here at church, though that's awesome, but in every single area of your life. And my hope is that you'll move along this way of the carpenter spectrum and grow in the areas of development that you are truly passionate about. I mean, some of you will be the next campus pastors, life group coordinators, children's workers and administrators here on staff that are helping to meet the needs of thousands of people throughout the communities where New Break serves. And others of you will find that you have moved from novice to apprentice to journeyman and see the need to facilitate a life group and help grow the vital spiritual community that you have actually begun to experience. And some of you will become the next CEOs and managers and executives because you have implemented these principles into the workforce. And if you learn how to lead your families like Jesus, I have no doubt that those of you whose families were once broken will be totally repaired. And here are a couple of next steps that I want to encourage all of you to take so that you apply what you've learned. So first, read Lead Like Jesus and read Lead Your Family Like Jesus. And then join or facilitate a Lead Your Family Like Jesus life group. Attend a Lead Like Jesus encounter workshop. Finalize your purpose statement, your picture of the future, and your personal values. Have at least one or two truth tellers in your life of the same gender. Talk to family, friends, and coworkers about what you've learned, and this will help you to remember what you've learned. And then establish goals that reflect your purpose statement, your picture of the future, and your values. And then journal about your successes and challenges and lessons that you've learned along the journey. Now that you have a list of next steps, discuss in your group how you plan on continuing to grow, retain, and apply what we've discovered in our group. As we wrap up this life group together, I hope that you see the potential that God has created you to realize by surrendering everything in your life to Him. And since this is our last week together, I would like for everyone in the group to share a prayer request that relates to the things that you've learned, like during your whole season together. And then our facilitator, he'll have you pray for the person and their prayer request on your left. So go around the circle until everyone is prayed over. And then after enjoying a time of prayer, discuss what's next for your group. I mean, we've learned so much in putting this stuff together in this series, and I want to thank you guys for being such an awesome part of the whole experience.